A steel cylinder contains 98.0 moles of oxygen gas at a temperature of 38 degrees Celsius and a pressure of 740 torr. After some of the oxygen has been used, the pressure is reduced to 332 torr and a temperature of 24 degrees Celsius. What mass of oxygen has been removed? Okay, so first we're going to have, we know that PV equals nRT, right? And R is a constant. So R is going to equal PV over NT. So no matter what gas we have, PV over NT will always equal R. What that means is if I have pressure 1, volume 1 over the first moles and temperature 1, that's going to equal, because it's a constant, P2, V2, my second moles, and temperature 2. So it says what mass of oxygen was removed. Well, what would be removed would be my initial moles, and we're going to subtract from that my final moles. So what I really want to do is, I've been given 98 moles. That was at the beginning, 98.0 moles. What I really want to do is solve for NF. So if I can figure out what my final moles are, this would be the moles removed, and then I can change that to grams. So I want to solve this equation for, we could use 1 or 2, or we could use initial or final, but ultimately what I'm solving for is N2. And you need to be able to solve for this in your head, do this algebra, but N2 is going to equal P2 V2 over T2. We're just simply moving this over. And then P1 and V1 will be on the bottom. And we're going to move these over to the top, giving me N1 and T1. So that looks complicated, but it all started with PV equals NRT. All right, so my pressures, even though they're in torr, and usually we change them to atmospheres, I don't need to change them to atmospheres because their units will cancel out. And pressure is proportional. Torr or atmosphere, that's proportional. However, with temperature, I'm going to need to change the T1 because the temperature in Celsius is not proportional. So T1 is 38 degrees Celsius plus 273. That's going to equal 311 Kelvin. And then T2 is 24 degrees Celsius plus 273. That's going to equal 297 Kelvin. Okay. And I know my pressures and the volume. It says steel cylinder. So I'm going to know that V1 equals V2. Because that's true, volume cancels. So that takes care of that. And then pressure 1, I'm just going to write all this down so I have it right in front of me. Is 740 torr. We could change that to atmospheres, but again, it would cancel out, and P2 is 332 torr. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to plug all these values, and I'm going to get my moles of oxygen after we removed some of the oxygen. So that's going to be 332 torr times my initial moles, which is 98.0 moles of O2, times my initial temperature, which was 311K. And I'm going to divide that by 740 torr. So you can see that my units will cancel here, so I don't need to worry about that. And T2 is 297 Kelvin. Okay, so it turns out then that N2 is equal to 46.0 moles. So now we want to calculate N moles of oxygen removed. So that's going to equal our initial moles, 98.0 moles of O2, and we're going to subtract from that 46.0 moles O2. So this then equals 52.0 moles O2 that was removed from the flask. If I take 52.0 moles of O2 and I multiply that by the molar mass, which is 32.00 grams of O2 per 1 mole of O2, I get 1,664 grams of O2. We only have 3 sig figs, so let's put that in the right number of sig figs. That would be 1.67 times 10 to the third grams of O2 that were removed from the tank. Okay, so let's take a look at this again. We use PV equals NRT. We know that that's always the case, so we can rearrange this so that PV over NT equals R. And R is a constant, so that means P2 V2 over N2 T2. We were given the first moles. We really wanted to calculate the second moles. We have a steel cylinder, so that's what allows us to cancel V2 and V1 and simplify this problem.